Hello everybody and welcome to Ad America TV. My name is James from the eGuides here at Ad America and we welcome our audience members joining us online. We hope that you're doing well and staying safe. Ad America is the United States Embassy's American Center and our mission is to provide a space for young Indonesians to learn more about the United States. In this episode, we will be having Global Entrepreneurship Week, how to sell your idea. But before we begin, let's break the ice with a little game. The movie Joy, starring Jennifer Lawrence, is about the inventor of the Miracle Mop, who sold her product on television, selling more than 18,000 mops in less than 30 minutes. What is her name? There are several options here. Is it Lori Guiner, Joy Manjano, Maria Telkis, or Madam CJ Walker? Stay tuned until the end of this program because we'll be giving a live shout-out to whoever can answer correctly on our social medias. Other than that, don't forget to take a selfie and tag at America's Instagram account. And now, without further ado, I would like to invite our moderator for today, Mas Muhammad Fikri Akbar, Senior Manager, School Partnerships from Sekolah.mu. Mas Fikri, the stage is yours.
Hello. Thank you, James. And hello, everyone. Mungkin kita juga nanti bisa bilingual ya, teman-teman. Mungkin yang hadir karena kita... mungkin ada beberapa teman yang beberapa obrolan-obrolannya kita pakai bahasa Indonesia bahasa Inggris, jadi ini kita anggap santai aja nih teman-teman gitu. Thank you banget semua teman-teman yang udah hadir di Global Entrepreneurship Week kali ini di Amerika. Thank you juga semua tim Amerika yang udah meramaikan ya acara yang aku bisa bilang nih sharing yang menarik ya tentang how to sell your ideas. Dan juga nih insyaallah juga nanti the speaker itself bukan hanya ngomongin title nih ya, tapi ngomongin journey experience yang menarik nih dari segi kita semua yang ingin pengen generally asking about how we improve to sell our ideas. Nah, mungkin perkenalan singkat juga dulu. My name is Muhammad Fikri Akbar. You guys can call me Fikri. I'm a senior manager and partnership at Sekolahmu. It's an edutech. So yeah. A thing or two about sell your ideas, hal-hal yang aku sendiri pun sangat sering melakukan dan sangat senang juga nih pengen bisa belajar bersama teman-teman semua di sini. Dan di sini juga yang pasti udah hadir ya, sesuai di poster, speaker kita, Adrian. Halo, selamat malam.
Halo.
Adrian.
Halo, Bar.
Siap. Apa kabar? Nah, tapi ntar dulu sebelum Adrian akan nanti share-share pengalaman ya, kita di awal-awal mungkin sedikit pemanasan juga dikit, sambil mungkin ada beberapa yang akan join tengah-tengah, karena nanti juga pasti main eventnya insya Allah akan lebih ramai lagi nih ya, para teman-teman yang hadir, dan mungkin juga ada beberapa yang lewat streaming dari device lain ya. Nah, ngomongin seller ideas nih, nanti sebelum Adrian akan share perjalanannya gitu ya, mungkin ada teman-teman bisa sedikit cerita nih ya, what is your aspiration and why do you come to this event nih teman-teman? By chat aja, boleh jawab dengan kata-kata huruf ya, huruf aja E atau C. Jadi E atau C itu menggambarkan aspirasi teman-teman nih kalau di ngomongin sell your ideas tuh lebih ke as entrepreneurship gitu ya, yang memang pengen building sendiri atau yang for a career gitu, career development yang memang ya nggak harus bikin sendiri, tapi it's for my career development, I want to learn better to sell my ideas to my colleagues or to my partners or even to my boss gitu. Boleh mungkin nih sambil di chat-chat ya, sambil kita lihat nih kira-kira nih nanti sell your ideas nih kita bisa nanti nyesuaiin ya ke teman-teman lebih pengennya yang lebih ngarah ke bahas banyak entrepreneur atau ke as a career nih. Boleh kalau misalnya sambil nanti di chat tulis aja E atau C ya, ini kita sambil lihat juga. Nah, mungkin nanti sambil kita nunggu nih ada beberapa yang akan ngasih tahu dikit ya tentang harapan-harapan gambaran ya dari dua antara yang entrepreneur atau karir itu. Boleh nih mungkin sedikit intro sebelum nanti kita mulai the main event, sharing the journey and experience from Adrian in his story of developing the selling idea or idea selling technique ya. Oke, Adrian, kan bisa di unmute nih dulu, Adrian.
Ya, gimana, Bang?
Iya. Nah, nanti akan ada slide-nya nih ya yang akan menarik pasti juga teman-teman akan bisa belajar. Cuman kalau sedikit spoiler dikit nih mungkin Adrian nih, kira-kira kalau ngomongin soal ideas yang akan kita bahas malam ini nih, sambil kita nunggu tadi ya chat-chat yang mungkin akan ada muncul dari teman-teman. Kira-kira nih gambarannya Cellular Ideas as a apa nih Adrian nih kalau dari yang akan kita bahas malam ini?
I think if we talk about sell or pitch idea, most people will assume it's all about business or entrepreneurship. Both of us coming from business background coincidentally. But as you said, in most jobs today, you need to deliver something, and to deliver that, you need to communicate, right? So I think to sell is to gain trust, and that's it. Jadi kayaknya kalau dibilang tadi ya even optionnya entrepreneurship atau corporate, yes, definitely gitu ya. Tapi in any other career or even personal life ya. Jadi kayaknya kan banyak problem tuh miscommunication gitu ya atau apa. I think it's still the same karena sell your ideas itu also about delivering value gitu. Mungkin nanti makanya mungkin lebih relevan some personal experience gitu ya daripada profesional. Because it's just very basic ya kayaknya sih Bang. Mungkin katanya spoiler ya. Mungkin kalau
ya ini spoiler dikit ya. Sebelum kita panasin mungkin teman-teman tadi ada yang dari streaming device lain dan lain-lain. Gambarannya mungkin juga seperti Adrian bilang kalau boleh sedikit share nih buat mancing dikit ya teman-teman ya. Kayak aku pun juga datang background sebagai berangkat waktu belajar Cellular Ideas as entrepreneur nih. Cuman bener nih kayaknya di sesi kali ini Cellular Ideas tuh bisa dibilang it's about everything juga ya, bukan as an entrepreneur aja gitu. Kalau bisa dibilang ngomongin sesimple miscom pun itu karena maybe we can learn a bit better nih about selling your ideas because everything that we communicate, kalau kita rasa kayaknya, belum nangkep nih gitu sama sesimple colleague kita gitu ya, nggak ngerti sama ide-ide kita. Well, this is the place that an event ya, yang kita nanti bisa ngebahas nih. Gitu. Kadang selling your ideas nih kayaknya as a general self development juga ya, Adrian ya, yang akan kita bahas nih kayaknya malam ini ya.
Actually our conversation tonight, it is conversation, but we may pitch something to the audience, right? Even some committees be at America, right? So if they don't trust the message, right? Then we're not doing this conversation.
Yeah, we're not doing this.
Nah, jadi. Tonight. Yes, jadi bisa tenang apa aja sih bar mungkin ya itu so no pressure I think to both of us the good thing
of course no. Yeah. Itu ya sedikit spoiler basic of selling ideas, no pressure, don't falter to pressure teman-teman. Jadi ya mungkin itu sedikit intro. Nah ini mungkin aku akan langsung mempersilahkan, jadi teman-teman enjoy your seat ya, cari posisi PW. Nah, ini mungkin sambil Adrian akan siapin slide-nya gitu. Tonight we will talk about how to improve and how to sell your ideas, our ideas to be better, not just and tadi mungkin aku mancing dua pancingan entrepreneur dan karir itu sebagai mempermudah ya, tapi tadi kita bilang we will learn more about the general self development about selling your ideas gitu. Nah, mungkin boleh kalau sudah siap Adrian bisa di share screen dan kita akan langsung mulai nih.
Kelihatan screen-nya?
Yes, dia okay. In my view screen is already okay. Up.
Okay, give me a moment. Okay, good evening everyone. Thanks for the opportunity to At America, of course, to you, Victor, so we can have a conversation, and of course to the rest of you. It is a conversation, right? We should hear more. Then we talk more, right? That's about selling. That's at least what my my understanding in my career, if not personal life. So yeah, I think I'll take 15 minutes at least, if not near 20, right? For the next some of my thoughts, right? And I'm willing to hear more from Fikbar. That's the most important. How the moderator can challenge me, right? I could be wrong, could be not, I don't know. And probably, of course, from the rest of the audience, right? So, currently, again, this is my personal thoughts. I'm not representing any entities that I will share to you. But my daily job is a management consultant with KPMG. People used to call it the Big Four accounting firm, right? Because they knew KPMG as an accounting firm. So they're mainly doing audit and tax, for example, right? But they're actually doing a lot of stuff. We are operating more than 140 countries in final year 2020. We are employed more than 200,000 people. The clients are business, government, public sector, non-profit, so it really depends. But my role specifically is only around management consulting. So I'm providing strategic advice on business and operating model to financial services client, banking, insurance, payment, most of the time. So as you know, there are a lot of trends around digital banking and financial services, right? And lastly, their focus is to grow, right? They need to know how to grow. And most of the time, that's my scope of work. I'm doing that to giving some suggestion, right? Some thought. And of course, providing solution. But I want to, well, today, I spend most of my time to speak about purpose, right? Why is I'm working here, right? So number one, they do have a purpose to make a difference today while making the world a better place for future generation. Of course, it's broad description, but it's aligned with something that I do in my career. I've worked in sort of multiple different industries. But yeah, it's never been about the technical expertise, at least from my perspective, right? It's about the purpose. Number two, KPMG aggressively investing in ESG, environmental, social, and governance. So a lot of sustainability focus around, and it's an investment with real dollars towards some agenda, right? So I see that as important on top of course the management consulting services. And to share a little bit what I did before, I just graduated actually from my MBA in the US, Boston in particular, and I had been grateful as a virtual graduation speaker, class of 2020, right? So we are the pandemic generation. so everything was virtual, unfortunately, but I managed to get most of my, two-thirds of my MBA in physical environment, actually. I am a founding member of Alumnus. So this is it was formed years back, but it now formally formed again. So it's the association from US alumni. And we're going to have Alumnus Summit actually next week, just to share to you guys. It's the first one. And I think most of my sharing today is around what I did when I was in the US, right? So it's a lot of experiment, as Vikbar said. I was engaging in so many different communities. I just keep coming to events, to professional networkings, just to know how the US corporations and the US business leader things, right? So I was involved in Boston New Technology, the TEDx Beacon Street, which only younger than 15 years old speakers that day, and Boston FinTech Week, Hal Price Regional North America, so on and so forth. And most of those, again, are how I understand about business, right? I need to speak with people and listen more. I had a Bachelor of Management or Entrepreneurship from SBM ITB. And lastly, as I said it before, I work in multiple different industries. So I hope today I will be broad enough to speak about any other industry. So I think Bar and the rest of the audience, today I'm gonna propose to speak only on these three areas, right? About yourself. So in this case, I'll tell my own story about your audience, right? You need to pitch to a specific audience, if not to multiple audiences, right? You need to understand this. And lastly, your own pitch. So most people spend most of the time on the latter, the last one, right? You assume that your pitch will basically the one who convinced people, right? Or anyone. I don't think so, right? It's all about you. It's all about your audience. What this they really want. And again, of course, pitch is still important, but this is the technical aspect out of it. So let's start with yourself, right? Myself in this case. So years back, when I was graduated in my bachelor's, right? Assuming most of you guys are in early stage of career, I had no focus, like literally. And I did not want to focus, right? Because I don't know what I really want to do around that time. So I spent most of my time learning everything, right? Marketing, operation, finance. I'm thinking to do my grad school, my postgraduate. At that time, there was no trends on digital startups, right? Or unicorns. There was none. So you guys can imagine how long I've been graduate. And of course, corporate career, right? Which where I'm focusing at then for the last several years. Football, right? I love playing futsal. So I'm just doing this all the time. Game. I'm into game. Most of and anything that interested that I'll try it. I play music a lot. So I don't really spend much on my undergrad, actually, because I'm just doing a lot of stuff. And of course, I do have also interest in industry, right? If you now applying for jobs, you need to understand which industry you want to focus on, right? It have different functional requirements or the same, right? You don't know. At that time, energy, oil and gas was the most interesting because of the compensation. I was working in petrochemical initially. And then banking, of course, is very popular, telecommunication, emission relax. But now my focus are very specific, right? I wanted to learn more the intersection between financial services, business strategy, and digital and data. So just letting you know, all this focus is not instant, right? You may take a lot of time to really think through what you really want to do. And I think it's fine, right? It's not about whoever the first that understand your focus, then you are really good at it. I don't believe in that personally, but of course, and everyone is different, right? And then when we talk about ideas are everywhere, right? We now have internet. When I graduated years ago, internet is different. Was different, slightly different, right? But today, you can literally do everything, work everything, study everything over the internet. Even this session is in virtual, right? So, but you need to understand how to focus, right? At some point on your life. Could be fast, early, or could be late. So I just want to share this concept of opportunity cost, right? When you make a decision on a specific option, you might decide not to do something else, right? And this alternative option that you did not do is actually actually opportunity cost. And most people never think through this, right? And opportunity cost is not accounting, right? It's not about the cash flow or whatsoever if you're studying finance. It's about understanding that your alternative decision is not better than what you decide at certain point. And it is important because you then can define your limitation. Then you can move forward and focus on 1, 2, 3 things. In my life experience, this is what makes me then understood what I valuable at and then provided to the communities, right? To the companies, to investor, the clients, so on and so forth. And again, we're still talking about ourselves, right? It's all about trust. Fikbar can trust me now when I'm speaking or not. I don't know, right? You guys can trust me or not. App America can trust me or not. I really don't know. Because most people, individuals or anyone, mostly they have preconception and cognitive bias, right? When you see a guy working in consulting, wearing glasses, and then, I don't know, wearing a fancy shirt whatsoever, but probably you assume this guy are studying a lot, right? Could be or could be not, right? But it is important because in order to pitch idea, then you need to gain trust, right? And to gain trust, at least in my, again, professional experience, there are two different and this or distinct approach, right? Either you tell how you've been executing a certain idea, which is a story about what you do today or what you did in the past. Or the other one is about the future. And it is different, of course, because then you need to show how persistent you will be in pursuing this idea. And most of this kind of idea is nothing to be found, right? It's new thing. they no need to put historical facts or whatsoever, but your what you did in the previous year. And this is where the young generations are thriving, right? The Gen Z. And I see this is very different, and you need to understand which one that you need to again align with what you do. And then the second point is your audience. There are, of course, many kinds of ideas to pitch to different audiences, right? I am a management consultant, so I need to pitch to my client most of the time, right? Either for a solution, or I literally persuade that I can help them, right? This is just part of the job. Or you could be Fikbar, right? A product manager, then you need to convince some guy in the software engineering side, or programmers, or even someone in HR, right? That you need to summon to help you whatsoever. And it is, of course, different environment, different kind of ideas. You can be original or not, it depends. The third one, an entrepreneur, which Fikbar, I think, pointed out. If you're an entrepreneur, then you need to convince a new idea to investor. Because without it, you will not get it, adequate equity to go forward, right, from the very beginning. And lastly, I just took example, the actual pitching, right? The value proposition of a brand manager. If you're leading a brand and you convince a specific key message to your audience, then you need to understand the consumer needs. This is where the market research, I was a market research before this. All the science are important, right? Because you need to understand the data, how the consumer currently consume your product, or you just need to validate it or just test it. But the complexity will come because you don't know who are your audience really, right? If you're a consultant, you can as well explain to your client, but at the same time, your boss might not agree with you. And you need to convince both of those stakeholders, right? Those audience. If Fikbar then managed to convince software developers, then how about the designer, right? Designer seeing it from art perspective. So the same idea can be just totally different for different audience. An entrepreneur, how about the consumer, right? The consumer do not really care how you will get your money to run your business. They will buy your product if they think it's valuable. And lastly, I took the example as a brand manager, right, in marketing. How about you convince your vendor in marketing agency, right? Because you want to display a certain key message, but then you need to get help from other third party. And it is difficult because then it's very possible they will assume it briefly. This is what I meant previously on preconceptions and cognitive bias, because human psychology teach us that it just happened. And it's not about smart or not, right? It's just about a human with different life experiences will judge differently on anything. But to help you guys understand better, right, which audiences need what, you can just start to listen. So this listening aspect are very, very, very important because it will help you limit your options. When you have a tons of ideas, right, I gave an example on the internet, you can just browse everything you want. But then which one that is really about you and your audience, then you need to get a feedback. But again, most people try to listen, but they just listen for the sake of themselves, right? So I just show you one example. This is just one of a framework in psychology. Level one, listening to impress, which most people do it, right? Probably I'm not now doing it. When Fikbar talk or ask anything, I can just try to listen, but I might not care, right? Number two, listening to learn. So I hope today I will learn, right? So I'll try to listen to anyone. And lastly, this is the most important, listening to understand, right? Because with different audiences in different environment, you will need to talk differently. You cannot generalize everyone because everyone need different needs. And this is, I think, the one of the key about your understanding your audience empathetically. And there is a lot of framework, right? Design thinking. Right, and then you can do agile methodology when you need to reiterate your product into a certain level, and you introduce some minimum viable product. But I don't think it's much more fundamental than that, right? Because if you're listening wrongly, then why would you reiterate? you're just creating even more rubbish product for your customer or your investor, right? It depends. And lastly, your pitch, right? I think most business graduates, myself, Fikbar probably, are teaching themselves about it. But as you can see, I don't think it's the most important for the whole concept of pitching or selling. That's why a lot of entrepreneurs not coming from business background. Because pitching is also, as of course, about technical knowledge in business. But then what if you're doing different kind of product, different kind of service? I was starting my career in petrochemical. It is a very complicated and challenging for me, right? Because I need to understand the whole chemical fundamentals, right? I need to study chemistry. Meanwhile, I have no interest around it. So pitching, it really depends. And the reason I said this is not the main focus, because you can just do this lastly. Because you can study it after. I'll give you one example what I do in my work, right? Just for the sake to make it relevant. I'm suggesting we need to focus on what makes our idea different, right? Because now I think on the right side, it's very common, right? Number of unicorns worldwide. Everyone in the media talk about unicorns, like any media, you can name it. And you see United States is the most, China, India, United Kingdom, Germany, South Korea, Israel, Brazil, France, Switzerland, and Indonesia, right? We are the fourth largest population, and we are the top 15 largest economy in the world, and we are here. So it should be a good news, right? Because we're now among having the largest number of unicorns in the world. But on the left side, as you see, based on the latest data, which any one of you can also access it, there are more than 64 million small and medium enterprises. And 13% of those, which around 8 million, are available in various digital platforms. Can I say digital startup? Maybe, or maybe not, right? It depends. But then if this data correct, if this statistic correct, then the proportion of unicorns coming off all the small medium enterprise are only 0.00006.25%. So the point is, ideas are also about executing. Everyone can just make ideas, right? That's why it depends whether your idea is original or not. That's number one. But number two, how do you make it into reality? Because people will only trust you when you really show. I shared it earlier, right? Either you do it something in the past, you did something in the past and was really, really good. So you're the expert. So most people coming from corporate background then becoming entrepreneur do this, or you just very persistent pursuing this dream, right? Dream is all about something intangible and you have not reached it at this moment, but you may reach it. But again, to show you the facts and the reality, you can see this as opportunity or challenge, right? Because we may need or at least develop more unicorns in the future because of this opportunity. But again, today's discussion is not about what. It's not about the pitching technique whatsoever, even though it's important, but it's more about why and how. Why your idea matters, right? What are the vision? Do you have strategy? Do you have key objective to achieve it? What are the key metrics? Are you serving something to your customer? Is it valuable? And how to make things done, right? So all of this pyramid visualization are to show you cannot focus only on the tip of the iceberg, right? You need to understand there are much effort that you need to do to achieve. And where are your ideas, right? Is it a dream, as I said before? Or is it already a business case, right? Or you need testing, right? I assume like Fikbar, he's doing a lot of testing in order to make sure any digital platform enhance its certain feature expected, right? Or it's launch ready, right? Or it's failed, basically. But how we can make it success? That's the big question. And of course, only you know, because you can judge whether you already put a full effort or not. And again, as I said a little bit around failures, right? Myself being very privileged, as I'm being a very educated, right? But at the same time, getting your ideas into reality, it's totally about failures. You need to fail. I might fail tonight in pitching or showing or sharing this idea, right? But it is important because then the next one at America invited me again. I know how I can improve it. So if you are in your career, you are not failing much as you thought you could, I don't think you're doing it the right way, right? Because now you don't know how to fail, and then how can you can be you bounce back to be a better person, right? Because you can always plan, but in the future, a lot of uncertainty. We don't know what we don't know. So in order to be adaptive towards that, the only way your ideas need to be tested, right? You need to test it whether it's working or not. And if it's not working, then your idea are not that good as you thought it could be. To summarize some of my thoughts, again, ideas about yourself. You need to remember opportunity cost, yet do not get rushed, right? Because it takes quite some time to really know what you really want to do. And of course, that will shape your idea. If it's aligned with yourself, then it's fine. But if it's not aligned, even though it's a good idea, no one will trust you. Different audiences have different expectations. Feedbacks are fundamentally what makes your idea getting better day by day. And what makes your idea different, right? Because there are a lot of people, a lot of ideas, a lot of consumers, if you talk about business. So focus on what makes it different, not what makes it better, right? Because anyone can just mirror and copy you in any way, somehow. Find out your why and how. Take most of your time doing that. Do not focus on the what part, because then you can learn from others if you want, if you're eager enough to ask questions, right? Knowledge are key. So if you're now talking only with people that around your expertise, you might don't know what happened outside your inner circle, right? And lastly, failures, right? Please seek failures. Again, I assume most of you guys are a young, early career audience, right? You need to fail more because you don't know what you don't know, and the future will just keep changing time goes by. Actually, that's it from me, Bar, and the rest of you. Please add my LinkedIn. So I'm asking you to chat me. Right? Let's be friends. And lastly, I said earlier about alumnus. So it's new. Next week, there will be the first alumnus summit. This is the link. Of course, you can check it if you want. But please add my LinkedIn. That's the more important, probably. So I think that's it, Bar.
Okay. Thank you so much, Adrian. Dari yang tadi seperti spoiler ya, not lying, it's very comprehensive ya. I think this is a very comprehensive presentation about selling your ideas. Tadi kalau misalnya dibilang kita awalnya itu memancing ya, gambaran as an entrepreneur, as a career gitu. Tapi ya tadi ada salah satu beberapa framework bahkan ya bisa kita pakai ngomongin kita selling your ideas ini lagi di tahapan apa. Lagi ngomong sama siapa, dan kita sendiri udah menyesuaikan sama lesson learned kita nggak gitu. Nah, mungkin aku juga ngeliat nih dari teman-teman, ada yang dari Instagram Live juga, hello people from Instagram. Jadi jangan malu-malu, feel free to ask if anyone wants to jump in the conversation. Ya tadi ya, seperti Adrian bilang, we treat this as a conversation, not just like one way webinar. So, anyone who wants to jump into the conversation, yeah, let's go. But as a moderator, I will jump in first. I have the privilege. So Adrian, I think in the presentation, I think that the one of the concept dan yang tadi juga sangat bagus ya teman-teman, mungkin di summarize di akhir tadi bagus banget, tapi tadi balik lagi di awal tuh ngomongin mengenal diri kita sendiri juga dulu nih, about before selling our ideas. Tapi ya we need to understand ourselves, our condition, our current context gitu. Nah, tapi kalau ngomongin dari pengalaman Adrian nih, yang kalau bisa dibilang tadi ya, terlepas dari title nih ya, tapi kan kalau ngeliat dari journey ini, as an, kurang lebih ini eksperimentalis juga ya, people yang dare to speak lah nih tipenya nih Adrian. Nah, dari proses dulu mengenal gitu gimana nih, do you feel like there is a changing in your style ya, about you selling your ideas, like have you ever felt that you are more like short talks but jelek gitu ya kalau Indonesianya short but sharp shooter, I think like when you talk it's just short but hit the right of the spot, or you have experienced yourself to become more like a narrative style who more theatric, like so how about your journey on developing yourself and learning about yourself to cater your style on selling your ideas.
Thanks ya Bar ya. Semoga pertanyaan ini gue bisa tanyain balik juga ke lu kali.
Ya, boleh ya. Benar-benar.
Ya mungkin kan orang again ya, orang beda-beda ya. Dari saya sendiri juga mungkin berubah ya Bar ya. Dulu fundamentally belajarnya tentang entrepreneurship gitu ya. Jadi how to make idea into reality, it is something that I learned theoretically, right? When I had my graduate, right, years ago. So it's totally different journey because in my case, I knew the concept. And I we had a lot of great entrepreneurs as lecturers already from the very very beginning, ya kan? Jadi udah lihat nih, ini ada orang-orang kok keren banget ya, ngapain aja sih gitu kan? But the big gap, at least in my experience, I really don't know how to do it right in operation perspective. We talk a little bit around marketing, how to make all this value proposition into reality, I don't really know. Oleh karena itu, I assume if I work in corporate first, then I would know how to do it much better because I know it already how to pitch idea, right? But during my career, I never get satisfied, right? I try to focus on one industry or one function. It seems that I thought I knew it everything in any my career. So I started in my petrochemical, then I moved to financial services. I am focused as management consultant. I was doing some digital market research. What I realized, and of course I prepared for this session, right? It really depends on the situation, Bar. I mean, kalau I assume in your situation, right? Again, product manager is a very hype kind of career today. You do this every day. That's what I understand. Because you need to make sure all stakeholders are aligned, but you need to make this as positive as you could because you need to gain trust, right? Paling bedanya, to answer your point, I thought there must be some great theory that I can use, then I can just keep repeat in all my career experiences, but there is truly nothing in our own way. Even if we could, we just probably executing or pitching the wrong idea. Jadi dari saya sendiri ya, got a lot of feedbacks throughout my career, my personal life that I never listened, but. And I just realized that for after years, right? Jadi itu justru in my case, I'm doing that to everyone, anyone close with myself, right? So it's so easy for me to understand, then when I realize it, it is a problem, then I need to change, right? So what I did, I just being silent, probably, Bar, because I said it before, just listen more will make yourself even better, Bar, even tonight, right? I try to understand your questions, for example, in better context, so I can respond it better. I think ideas are about that. Mana ada sih sekarang investor yang lu pitch idea lu ke gua gitu ya. Tapi terus this investor, in case if he's interested, he cannot ask. Kan nggak ada situasi kayak gitu kan. So if you can putting value only in the first 2 or 5 minutes in any conversation, then the conversation will go on, will continue. Gitu sih Bar. Jadi difficult person or difficult interaction happen probably because we don't know yet the person, and we are probably the problem. That the case with my own experience years back, Bar.
We are our own problem, ya. Mungkin applies to everything.
Ya, kan pasti nggak sadar dong kalau kita yang salah dong. Masa disalahin, nggak mungkin.
That's the point. I think the hardest part is realizing the lesson about we are the problem and we need to change a little bit about ourselves. I think that's the biggest takeaways and the biggest challenge. So like jumping on to that in the context of realizing that there's some part of ourselves is the one that causing trouble. Mungkin ini bagi teman-teman ya yang mungkin masih fresh grad atau yang baru-baru ini yang mungkin dulu ngerasa kayak tipe-tipe introvert, merasanya mengakuinya. Sebenarnya introvert juga selling ideas, nggak apa-apa ya teman-teman. Tapi kan ada ya biasanya talking about mental blocks or dalam keadaan sekarang nih ya yang mereka ngerasa kayak I still cannot sell my ideas right. There's some mental blocks that blocking me to even develop and learn about better. So they realize they are contributing to the problem, but they cannot see it in a solutive way. So like, gimana menurut Adrian? Do you have any thoughts or advice for the people who felt that mental block?
Yeah. Ini sebelum jawab yang ini, tadi menarik juga, tadi Victor bilang, we need to change a little bit, right? I like that word little bit, because it is true. Daripada susah banget berubah, radikal banget radikal. Gitu ya, towards a certain extreme gitu kan, which most people have that plan, I'm pretty sure. If you want, misalnya nih ya, aduh udah lama nih nggak olahraga ya, kita olahraga yuk gitu. Terus biasanya put targetnya tuh luar biasa gitu ya, 20K per day gitu misalnya. It's not realistic, right? At least for me, I don't know about you. So I think change is also about that, right? We try to do things differently. And it's okay, we just move a little bit, right? And felt it. Whether it's right or not. Nah, terus tadi kalau Fikbar tanya soal
mental blocks.
Misalnya ada introvert atau extrovert, atau it's actually from yourself, right? You're overthinking it, probably. You assume a lot of information, which is not the reality, probably, which happened in my case as well. Again, it's about understanding yourself, right? I knew I was, I am extrovert. And probably you can see it easily. So I know I need to listen more, right? Because I spend most of my time and gaining energy from conversation like tonight. But when I talk with someone who are not, I need to relax. It's all about deeper conversation, right? And if you said about mental blocks, it is very complex because then you must assume something, right? I said in my sharing earlier, about preconception and cognitive bias. Human mind fundamentally think that way. They will collect historical information and then they will judge and perceive value in the future based on that experience. Jadi, kadang-kadang orang yang gak punya pengalaman atau gak punya knowledge sama sekali, probably is the best person to ask about your ideas, right? Because he or she may not just judge you on any way. And coming back to mental blocks, most of the time, at least in my experience, it is coming from yourself because it happened badly in your life and you just don't want to get through it again. That's why getting failures are the key, probably, Bar. Jadi, ya jangan ambi-ambi banget lah. Mungkin itu aja kali. Karena kita juga bisa salah ya. Kita bisa pitch idea, a billion dollar idea. And everyone praising you before. And then when you meet the investor in business situation, he said it is rubbish, right? Could be the investor is right, but could be not, right? You really don't know, but that failures taught you that there must be some other perspective to see your own idea. And again, it's your own choice to stay still with your idea, right? You can just defend your idea. Tadi lo bilang difficult person atau mental blocks. You can just not hear or listen to the audience that are not matters to your idea, right? So this is also important to understand who you need to speak to, right? Whom are those? Because if it's not relevant, unfortunately, no need to get consensus, which I think I said it earlier. Gitu mungkin, Bar. Mungkin agak-agak toxic lingkungannya gitu kan, jadi
jadi gak perlu jadi people pleaser lah ya.
Yeah, I think so. I think so. Be nice to everyone, of course, right? I don't want to say just be very bold on your opinions whatsoever. You could, but be nice, right? You can reject as polite as you could, because sometimes, occasionally, you're in the position of being pitched, right? So you need to as well hear and give judgment whether I don't know this or his or her idea is a good or not, and so it's work the other way around as well. But
in summarize, I think the point of the mental block itself, like we come to the point first we come to realize that we need to learn from ourselves, within ourselves, like the first one of the point of the slide tells about that, we understand ourselves. But at the second part, we also learn about how to realize or how to develop the self-awareness into more a productive way, not like a mental block way. It's through the process itself. Mungkin salah satu hal yang makanya perlu kita tekanin ya, teman-teman ya. Jadi ya melangkah itu dan belajar itu ya penting gitu. Jadi balik lagi ke don't afraid to be failure itu ya, dan find the support system tadi ya, Adrian ya. Saat jadi kayak di saat when we feel like failure and feel drown enough to try, kayak udah enough try-nya, maybe it's time to find your that support system to just get the feedback from the people you comfort first, recharge your energy and get and you can be getting another feedback from the more people that maybe you feel tired of. I think that's the point. I think like ya, jadi bagi teman-teman ya, zaman sekarang apalagi ya, sesimpel kita ngepost di Instagram aja kan kayak ada aja yang bisa ngefeedback. That's just like a micro example of we selling our ideas, like oh we want to post some kind of after goes nih gitu kan, we want to sell an idea that this is a good habit that I'm trying to develop and we want to tell it to our friends, but maybe there's some kind of people who overthink, like ah nanti teman gua ngomongin kayak gini atau teman-teman. I think that's a real case in this kind of times when we are connected, hyper connected, and then we develop this overthinking. But tonight talks makes us realize, let's just go back to basic. Maybe because hal-hal yang berhubungan sama karir kita ya, tadi Adrian ya, yang ngomongin selling our ideas, itu juga bisa balik ke hal simple kayak tadi. Kadang kalau kita aja nge-post di IG aja overthinking, ya maybe we haven't find the right support system, we haven't developed that mentality to getting micro failures every day to get that feedback. So yeah, mungkin itu bahayanya teman-teman ya, kalau misalnya tadi kita akhirnya tidak mencoba keep learning from the ourselves and through the lens of others, seeing ourselves, itu yang bikin kita jadinya malah terjebak gitu ya. Dan tadi jadi kayak it's like a lingkaran setan aja mungkin ya, cycle yang akhirnya kalau kata Adrian tadi bilang, sebagai orang yang mungkin tadi nggak terlalu relate sama mental block ya, kayak tadi ya bisa dibilang kalau dari segi budaya orang Batak ya udah dari awal suka selling your ideas, tapi bahkan ekstrimnya itu dia, orang yang udah extroverted banget pun akhirnya menemukan kesadaran sendiri untuk learning, listening juga gitu, and some part gitu. Tapi kata kuncinya tadi ya, setelah nyemplung ya, jadi ya, setelah going through all the journey. So like, yeah, so itu mungkin teman-teman ya, enjoying the journey and recharge when you feel tired or you feel drowned, and absorb that feedback. That's I think the basic way. Nggak perlu di overthinking untuk develop our idea selling quality. Yeah. I think that's quite the summarize of it. Yeah, Rian.
Ya mungkin ini aja sih, nambahin dikit bar soal poin tadi ya. Jadi waktu saya sendiri di apa sempat studi di US gitu ya, I knew or at least I assume that I need to spend most of my time not in the class but to engage with as I working in business and consulting, I need to engage with this business leader right in the US. And then when I did that, I saw that they are very confident on their opinion, and even it makes them sometimes fight each other every day, right, in business environment. I generally don't see that in Indonesia. Most people will seek synergy, right? Will seek collaboration, we'll seek togetherness, right? In most of the cases, I did not see it in the US. In the US, there are a lot of conflicts, a lot of, again, I said, personal opinion will drive even thinner lines between your work and your personal life in this sense, because if you're very strong in your idealism, in your activism, then you will say it out loud your personal values, right? And it is not common in Indonesia, I think. So even I got connected and still be friend with all these corporate leaders in US just by involved in some of personal activism kind of purpose, right? So I'm not saying we need to be very personal in order to know this or guy or lady, right? But it's truly about what you really believe. And American societies and corporate cultures are valuing that. They are seeing your technical attributes, of course, your professional knowledge, of course, but they will seek leader that will pursue some core values that this organization represent. I don't see it generally in Indonesia. So I hope. So this is just my hope. We can see this even more. So constructive feedback and conflicts, right? It's how we shape better ideas and execute, right? Because ideas is all about get things done. It's not about talking in a Friday evening, TGIF they said, right? It's not, right? It's about pitching tonight and then let's meet tomorrow, but let's create something, right? And in order to do so, you need to say your opinion and make conflicts after. Because it's then the only way you need to, you can collaborate with people from different perspective and different functional expertise, right? Ultimately, it's all about that. I cannot see any other way to do so if we're not doing it. And probably, as I show a little bit on my one of my decks earlier, in the United States now they have 288 unicorns. China have 133, right? Indonesia, we have 5 today, which is already great news to us, right? So how we can pursue it and accelerate it, right? And achieve it, right? So we need more people to think this way, need more people to spend their time doing things, right? Not pitching ideas only. Yeah, so these mental blocks can even bring into that business paradox, right, Bar? Because if we assume everything you do now is working, then why we're not scaling up, right? Because business is all about scaling up. We need to reach more audience. Doesn't matter if you're B2C or B2B. And then having enough margin, right? Because margin is the way you invest and grow your company then. Without that, you cannot grow your company, nevertheless. So all of these things are some of technical aspects around business concepts. But the only way you can understand this, if you can understand, again, how to differentiate your ideas towards understanding, again, yourself and your audience. You're already adding that, but hope that helps.
Yes. And then untuk wrap up juga, in the context of the our culture is also evolving ya. Mungkin teman dari kita yang like the hyper-connected era ya, secara nggak sadar mungkin ya, kalau tadi kita bilang netizen war, keyboard warrior, sudah banyak yang di Twitter.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
I think
mungkin ada bagusnya juga ya, Bar, berarti ya.
Yeah, kita bisa ngambil positifnya ya, like Indonesian people start trying to be more dare to be spoke, walaupun pakai akun palsu mungkin ya. Tapi
nah,
mungkin itu yang
bisa. Sebenarnya benar tuh, Bar. Nah, jempol-jempol yang buat komen-komen itu, nah, dipakai alternatifnya buat generate something dong, writing something gitu kan. If you can learn programming, probably you code something. Yeah, so the same energy, right? But different perspective can probably have totally different outcome, Bar.
In way kayak kalau tadi kita bilang kita ngambil hikmahnya aja ya dari para keyboard warrior di
Twitter itu,
I think many Indonesians start to develop their debate skill like this couple past 2 years, especially when we are at home, we go fighting hoax or everything like hopefully even the like kita yang kita pelajari juga ya, walaupun prosesnya painful ya, ini sesama masyarakat Indonesia harus merasakan semua hoax dulu. Tapi ya, hopefully that we learn about learning from the conflicts, we can develop our ideas better, to critically think better, who, why, and how should we sell our ideas. I think that's a really great sharing from Adrian. Dan tadi ya, mungkin ini menariknya kalau aku bisa bilang, dari pengalaman Adrian nih yang bisa, mungkin teman-teman yang relate, yang extroverted, saya belajar juga, learn about melunak ya, atau bisa dibilang lebih menyesuaikan tadi ya, kalau dari saya Adrian, kalau dari aku juga yang pengalaman yang mungkin lebih rada overthinkernya, tapi ya tadi with the process yang tadi kita bisa learning from failure ini, sebenarnya kata kuncinya sih about selling your ideas. Okay, mungkin ada dari teman-teman mungkin ada lagi yang mau ditanyakan before we wrap up. I think the conversation is already quite saturated ya. Mungkin tadi udah kita udah menemukan nih titik temunya. Tapi mungkin kalau misalnya from anyone people yang audience nih yang pengen ada menambahkan. Well, let's wait. I think I will count until 1, 2, 3 maybe. I think yeah. Yeah, I think dari teman-teman mungkin ini sambil masih mencerna dulu ya. And hopefully mungkin dari tim Amerika juga nanti akan bisa di republish lagi, and maybe other people who watch this later will take some one or two lesson and sharing from this event. I think it's already summarized well juga di PowerPoint-nya. Mungkin kalau misalnya ada yang sampai teman-teman yang mendengar ini di Instagram atau di Twitter, di Facebook, dan di Zoom, jangan lupa tadi mungkin sekali lagi Adrian bisa di-share itu, kalian ada link-innya, kalau ada yang mau connect nih. I think that's the best output ya, dari yang teman-teman bisa hadir nih, hadiahnya bisa langsung nanti connect sama Mas Adrian. Untuk tes latihan pertama selling your ideas ya, nanti kenalan di LinkedIn sama Mas Adrian supaya nggak sampai nggak dikacangin.
Nggak lah, itu beda lah, itu nggak butuh ini kok, itu butuh jempol-jempol maut aja bareng untuk ngechat.
Iya, atau mungkin mau di chat aja kali ya Mas Adrian untuk
nggak tadi LinkedIn. Nggak apa-apa kan Adrian Siregar kayaknya cuma ada 3 kayaknya di Indonesia.
Ya, di Google pun bisa.
Udah pernah ngecek juga kok, ada paling ya, salah-salah man. Dikit, 3-3-nya app aja.
Itu boleh tuh. Latihan seller ideas ke 3 orang berbeda. Jadi mungkin itu teman-teman, tadi salah satu hadiah penutup nih ya, tadi aku reminder lagi, jangan lupa connect to Adrian. Mungkin kalau ada yang mau connect ke aku juga ya, easy juga nyari, Fikbar aja, Fikri Akbar itu juga bisa nyari di Google. Let's do what we already agreed to do ya, ngomongin seller ideas, don't be afraid to trust and try to meet other people, learn from other people, so we can develop our selling ideas technique or our aspiration to sell our ideas better. I think that's it. Adrian, any closing statement?
Udah, thank you waktunya, Fikbar, teman-teman dari Amerika yang udah dengerin. Sampai ketemu lagi dan ngobrol-ngobrol lagi paling. Itu aja.
Yeah. Siap.
Selamat istirahat paling.
Yes.
Enjoy weekend.
Become insightful Friday night. Thank you so much Adrian again for the sharing. Thank you juga nih mungkin semua tim at America dan semua teman-teman nanti yang tadi hadir di Instagram, di Twitter, di Facebook, ada yang lihat juga, dan di Zoom juga. Have a good Friday night. Have a good weekend. Happy Global Entrepreneurship Week. Yeah, let's hopefully this ada tambahan spirit ya dan insight untuk mengeberkan nih mungkin sisi entrepreneurship kita. Have our entrepreneurial spirit flare up in this night. Thank you so much. Sebagai moderator, Fikri Akbar juga pamit. Serahkan kembali ke tim Amerika.
Thank you so much to our speaker, Mas Adrian, along with our moderator, Mas Fikri, for today's very informative session. Earlier in the event, we asked audience members a question. That question is, the movie Joy, starring Jennifer Lawrence, is about the inventor of the Miracle Mop who sold her product on television, selling more than 18,000 mops in less than 30 minutes. What is her name? And the correct answer to that is option B, Joy Manjano. Shout out goes to Nadia Chayadi from YouTube for answering correctly. And thank you to everyone who has participated. Don't forget to tune in next time for another chance to get a shout out from us. Now, you may be wondering, how could I develop an awesome idea for a place like this? It's very easy. All you need to do is go to our website at www.atamerica.or.id, select create a program, and click collaborate with us. All event proposals coming to us will be reviewed, and your event might be featured here soon. You can also subscribe to our newsletter for all our weekly updates. And that's it. That wraps this episode. It's been fun, but we have to say goodbye for now. Follow our Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram at ATAmerica for our fun contents, event updates, and so much more. Thank you again, everyone, for joining. My name is James, and we'll see you at the next AT America TV episode. Goodbye.